All right, we're going now to start working. Like I said, guys, before you start working on heavy stuff and doing this, safety first, of course. Safety first, because you might get really hurt bad and no one there to help you. So be careful. Always be cautious and safety first. Make sure you got all your tools, everything close to you, because you're doing this all alone. All right, guys, you see I got my stand there, I got my jack underneath my truck ready. I got my air compressor right there, so I'm using air to lift the jack, and we're going to start right now. Go to work. Always, guys, be cautious and make sure that you have something also in case of that stand broke or whatever, you have something holds the other wheel, you know, So I got another stand right there just for safety. And also supports the other stands, the other stand here, so then it don't take all the weight, you know? So that's another tip. Now we're going to open the hub.
Once I open it, the oil will drip.
But give it like a minute so oil moves to that side.
T4 socket.
It's harder when you have the tires on. Let me try. How about? Trying to use what I got. This is not actually a Hummer. Should have like this side. This size with this head. Not like this head. That's why I don't want to use it. There might break my damage.
Trust me, when you don't have the right tools, expect that you're gonna be working real hard a little bit. It'll take more time. So I will not end up just taking all the wheels, just all one wheel out. That's the best thing to do, because I can't get here to here because of my rim. It's so hard. Alright. So to open the nuts there, the bolts, you need 30 or no. 33 millimeters socket. Because of the silicone, the last time I put in there, it's stuck really. But if you can't see, it's dripping, it starts dripping off. So I will use the hammer again. What we will do, we can start. Then start, I guess I'm gonna use this. Don't keep hitting it the same spot, so change. Keep changing, so. You put your parts in a good spot, not get damaged. You guys, look, I'm not losing a lot of oil because all the oil is in there. So now it's cleaning that part, and place the casket and close it, tie it up. We're done. From the first axle. like using this to clean the dry silicone casket. It's easier for me. Everybody has something, I don't know. Let's use the best thing.
Mm-hmm.
I want to clean them really good. Show you now. And of course, whenever you use the metal brush on a die grinder like that, wear glasses. I forgot to wear glasses, so make sure. You see how clean out there? I just need to wipe them. Use some kind of brake cleaner or anything.
See how clean?
Yeah. Your truck deserves it, you know.
Thank you.
make sure you clean your pipe real good before you reinstall it. Make sure no dirt, no anything in there. Yeah.
Go get the half casket.
Sorry guys, I'm still looking for the half cast because I don't know where did I put the bag.
It's right there. Oh man.
Well, finally I found it. Well guys, I got, my family actually picked up the hop seal, but I don't like this, and I paid $3 for this. It's not the one I want, so I would have to take this back and get a metal one. Better, of course, from this. What is this? This is a carport. I don't know if it will work or not. I got it open, but I don't know.
sitting here and then, oh, I don't have a box.
Yeah, I don't have a box.
That's what he said.
She told him this is less than a dollar, I think. All right, guys, we're going to stop here till I exchange the seals. But I'm going to make another video for the front, because the front is different. Let me check them before we do that. Yeah, the front is different. This is better than that one. This is, it has like some weight, Stimco. But this kind, I don't know if it will work or not. I never had these, I never tried them. So, just don't have a good feeling about it. You know what, I'm going to install it. I'll install that one, I will finish the job. And if it did leak, I will change just one and take three back and get the bigger one. All right, guys, let's do that. Let's finish the video. Place that there. I don't have a silicone casket, but if you're going to use the silicone to make a casket, make sure you get the right one, the good one. The one special made for to make a casket with. Yeah, it's right there.
I don't see it here.
Yeah, that's okay.
Let me show you here what I got. And it did more.
And I put it all around the hop end there. This is what I got. I don't know where did I bought it from, but an instant casket. So it didn't work.
Put it back, you need to make sure it goes in the gear. So once it slides in there, it will find its way by itself. So you don't need to move your axle or nothing. Back in business. So I will not go in there without hammering it. You notice, guys, that I didn't engage, I didn't have, I have to engage the brakes or anything, because my parking brake is right here in the front axle. So you don't need to do anything here. Just lift it up and it will turn by itself. But if you're going to work on the axle that has your brake service, brake, parking brake, and all that, you would have to let the air builds up first, of course, with the brake on, and then put a jack, lift it up. Before that, engage your brake. And once you engage it, it's like you're taking the brake off that axle. Then you can't work on it. Doing wheel seal, whatever, tire repair, whatever, brake. So now we're going to reinstall the hub after we put the casket in there. Hopefully this works, so save time. Put the nuts back. Need a 24 socket. Tighten them up. You're back in business. Sorry guys, my gloves is bigger than my hand. The funny thing is, when you go Home Depot, they don't sell gloves like medium size. All they sell is large and extra large. Well, I need medium. So it's funny. Thank God. Large and extra large, no medium, guys. Okay, you brought large, extra large. Bring medium. There's a lot of people that their hands are smaller than really medium size, you know? A lot of people. So, what do we do? Let's get the job done. Battery sucked. Another bed. Guys, last step, which is put that tire back.
keep your place clean. Socket 33. And before you head out, guys, really actually get on the road, retorque it again and check the torque, because it might get loose. So if you guys like the video, please subscribe and like, because that will help me and motivate me to do this kind of videos. And I hope this video helps a lot of people over the road. And I wish everyone to have a great and blessed days and be safe on the road. All right, we'll see y'all in the next video. Thank you.